need opportunity. We need to see people, whether they are our friends or our enemies.
Well, you cannot make fundamental change without some amount of madness. In my case, this stems from non-conformity. The courage to turn your back on old formulas. The courage to invent the future.
Invent the future, yes, I agree, but that's if there is a future to invent, Thomas. You said, we cannot carry out fundamental change without a certain amount of madness. I agree with you, but does madness mean foolishness? Does madness mean doing the same thing over and over again and expect a different result? Does it mean that an enemy cannot become a friend if he has changed his ways? Does madness mean that we have to hold on stubbornly to an ideal of revolution that has even done more harm to the people than imperialism ever did?
What have they promised you in return for disowning all that you have ever been?
No one has promised me anything but truly waking up and trying to help the people. Thomas, it is our duty as patriotic Burkina Faso to wake up, to find that, to agree that we're wrong if we see that whatever it is in the past that we have done was wrong. Thomas, imperialism must have been part of the problem, but it is definitely not all of the problem.
Brother, when we woke the people, they stood up and imperialism crumbled. Don't force them back on their knees. Please.
They're already on their knees. Already grumbling.
Look, what we did was to help the people decolonize their mentality. Now we are working on reconditioning them to accept themselves for who they are. To accept and be proud of their situation. To take glory in it,
Support, Thomas.
Please, do not say we. You say you. You are the one working on it.
Thomas, what was François Mitterrand trying to say that he was evil for inviting Pierre de Montalbano in South Africa to France on a state visit? Thomas Sankara, who did the West when he said that Africa should not pay back their debts? Thomas Sankara.
Well, don't be comical.
What else is there to be not to be comical? The only person the whole world sees in this government as a serious person is Thomas Sankara.
You know that is not true.
You know that every single word I say is true.
Look, every single word of it. Please! Do you want to destroy the foundation of the house that we have built just because you do not like the color of the walls?
Must it be you that decides the color to repaint the walls? Must it be you that defines every single thing that we do?
I choose to ignore that question.
You will not ignore me, Thomas! You will not ignore me!
You are running out of choices, Thomas. You know that, don't you? As regards
it, I am not talking about
as regards death. All I said was that in its current form, it is imperialism controlled,
Thomas.
Look, death is a clever method to the conquest of Africa. Aimed at subjugating its growth and development through foreign rule. Each one of them, each one of us becomes a slave, a financial slave of the West that is a true slave. Look. It is the chains of this neo-colonial slavery that the revolution is supposed to break.
Thomas, what about our brothers and sisters that we enslaved? The ones that we have had here for centuries in Africa. Tribes attacking tribes and taking slaves as bounty.
Funny you now ask questions to which you already had answers long time ago.
Please, they brainwashed you.
Or is it that you never really believed in the first place? At least tell me one thing, brother. Do you at least remember why I asked for the debts to be cancelled?
No, no, I have forgotten. And you were the only person who knew that.
Huh?
The only person in Africa who properly, critically analyzed the situation. Huh? The only person in the whole world who could tell the truth.
No! Not me alone. You! I! Jerry Rollins, Henri, Jean-Baptiste, Stella, Samora, we all knew!
But I spoke, even though I did not like it or welcome the idea. I am the face and the mouthpiece of the revolution, not its soul.
The people are the soul of the revolution.
No, you are the revolution.
I am not. I am only trying to save the people.
By doing what exactly? By sacking all the teachers because they dare to protest? 1,800 of them or more?
I did not sack them. We sacked them.
And then you go to hire any charlatan off the street who was stupid enough to believe in a revolution that has lost its head?
The revolution, the teachers that we sacked were counter-revolutionary.
And then you threw them into the classrooms and you called them revolutionary teachers.
When we were only trying to protect the ideals of the revolution.
Do you know what that did to our educational system? Tomas, it destroyed it!
Look, the teachers that we sacked were... They did not want the people to start following the preaching that I gave them. That what has held us down this long is the neo-colonial way of thinking. Ah! They did not want our people to start thinking like Africans.
Thomas, is that what the other unions were guilty of? Huh? You banned them. The journalists, you arrested them. You cut down every single person that dared to stand up to the great Thomas Sankara.
You took the ideals of imperialism, the ideals of socialism that we all so treasured.
And just like Joseph Stalin, you twisted it. You turned it into a caricature of your impossibly idealistic version of heaven. What was about us, Thomas? You made about you.
Don't you dare! Don't you dare! Captain Blaise Campaure, don't you dare change history.
Oh, because I am white?
You think I do not know what you and your goons have been up to? Don't you dare turn away from me when I talk to you!
Oh, you fomenting the sect, poisoning minds, making our youths and revolutionary groups run amok and attack our people so that they can blame it on Sankara? You think I do not see what you are doing? Giving a dog a bad name before you kill it! Yes, I made mistakes. I made mistakes, but I apologize! Over and over again, I apologize on television to the people. I apologize. I pledged change. I tried, but those who the imperialists have been paying to frustrate my efforts would not let it work. But you have always been by my side. Every decision, every action. Do Captain Blaise Campaure. More than anyone else have ruled this country with me. So don't you come here and talk to me and like I have amnesia. Don't tell me stories that you yourself have made up and believe yourself. If there is anyone here who is guilty, it is you. You are the one with envy in your eyes, hate in your heart, poison on your tongue. If you do not have anything better to say, shut the hell up!
Thomas Sankara finally loses his cool. Do you not feel alive, Thomas? Huh? Do you not feel all the emotions? The anger, the hate, the envy, the vengeance? You're just like every one of us, Thomas. Human, like every one of us. The man Sankara.
They know you. You submitted to serve lowly, or was instead lifted to the status of a demigod. Captain Thomas Isidore Noel Sankara. We must have the strength. We must have the power. We must have the integrity. We must have the everything. And when we did not, the people lost faith.
Come on. I have the strategy ready.
What strategy?
I was speaking to Comrade Sankara and not you.
Are you snapping at me, Comrade Aluna? Huh?
What is this, Jojere? What are you doing here?
He was sitting out there, licking his lips and rubbing his hands like the devil he is. I'll be careful if I were you. Watch what you say. You think I am afraid of you? Or him? You are both lucky that I'm not the one sitting in behind that gate. I would have had you shot for treason.
Gloria Luna. Do you know who you are speaking to?
Yes.
The traitor of the revolution.
Captain Blaise Compaoré, the one who the French and the Ivorians have in their pocket.
I am speaking to you.
Yes.
And do you know that I can have you shot for insubordination?
Right. See what happens. The fool thinks his head is bulletproof. Maybe I should pull the trigger to find out if it is, Comrade Campbell.
Let us see first. We have the decency and the good sense to apologize.
I will never apologize to traitors.
Do you hear that, Master? Huh? Are you not going to say a thing?
What sense is there speaking to you? The ears that refuse to listen.
Are you going to watch Gilbert blow away the brains of your very good friend?
You can murder a revolutionary, Blaise, but you can never kill his ideas.
Gilbert, give us a name.
Gilbert!
And are you not going to ask your attack dog to leave us?
He has a name, Blaise.
He does? So then, are you not going to ask Comrade Aluna Traoré to
shoot? Comrade.
Well, I have made my choice. You made yours.
And you think that the people will honor you for this?
One day the people will hear my story in my voice, and they will understand the wisdom of my actions.
Your voice. That is if your journalist friend, Valerie Juru, ever gets to tell you.
Blaise, she is innocent.
We all are innocent. Victims. All of us.
One day, the people who use you now, they will drop you and the skills of our team.
Thomas, I am a survivor. And unlike you, I know when to switch sides. You see, I know that
The revolution only brings out the worst in people. So I am moving against it. I'm trying to save the people from themselves. Is it enough? Power was never meant for the common man.
Please. The man is only as good or as bad as the name that he is remembered by. One day, you will come to realize that your name is all that you fought. And never bet against the people. Choose.
Master, whatever happens to you after I leave that through that door, please help me. I tried to save you, to help you. But you chose to play God.
Please. Time will tell if you tried to help me, or if you tried to make it look like you tried to help me.
You know it in your heart that I tried to help you from us.
Whatever happens to me now, you, Pocard, Tibet, Jean-Baptiste, Mitterrand, Chirac, you already decided it a long time ago. Speech or no speech. So you see, I never had the power to help myself, even though you pretend that I do. I love you, brother. And like Judas before you, go and do what you must.
They talk to you, now be me they talk. Now Prime Minister Botha, they talk to you. Him say, this uprising will bring out the peace in us.
This uprising will bring out the peace in us.
Say, this uprising will bring out the peace in us.
This uprising will bring out the peace in us.
Say, uprising will bring out the beast in us.
This uprising will bring out the beast in us.
Give me KK, my argument.
I am worried about you. And there you are, dancing. Yes, brother, I celebrate. Your pacifism, turning the other cheek, being a sitting duck. No, brother. I celebrate victory.
Victory? Over what?
Human rights. I do not understand why you are so adamant about practicing this Mahatma Gandhi and Martin Luther King is thing. Let us be like Malcolm X and Toussaint Louverture. No. Let us be like us. Who are we? We are the ones who, when confronted with hard decisions, will take the hard and moral one. Instead of the easy and popular one. I do not understand. I do not. Listen to me now. This brother gets me all the time, man. Best musician in the world, if you ask me. Listen to what he says. He says that we fight against the beast of no nations. For them, the world is one nation that they want to rule. People ask why Bella died.
He gets me. He sees what I see. He feels what I feel. He believes what I believe in. Hear what he says. That we, one day, there will be a war of beasts. The beast that wants freedom and the beast that wants slavery. And together they will ha! And you know who will win, right? Traore, to remain true to myself and not keep on this track.
Honestly, even though I try really hard, I cannot figure you out. You are like Jesus, Muhammad, Buddha, Confucius with a sprinkling of Bomani all rolled up in one.
Every man has his race to run, Traore.
But you have run yours too fast. The people cannot catch up. And they believe that they have been abandoned. They can't even see you anymore.
You need to slow down to take them with you.
If not, the vultures that circle above will pounce on them and turn them against you.
That is why I have to leave this speech now.
Alright. Here is the strategy. Signed, sealed, and delivered.
You know, last week, the anniversary of Che Guevara, do you remember why I told the people that Che is an African?
Yes. You said, Che Guevara taught us to dare, to have confidence in ourselves. Confidence in our ability. He instilled in us the confidence that the struggle is our only recourse. He was the citizen of the free world that we are together beginning to build. This is why we all should say that Che Guevara is African and Burkinabe.
What if he didn't die so early? Would the revolution that will bring about a good and much more just world have survived till today? Would we have been ignited by the fire of his passion? And the answer I get is, blood has to water the tree of the revolution. Like Jefferson said, the tree of liberty must from time to time be watered with the blood of patriots and tyrants.
You see, the blood of patriots and tyrants, but you want only the blood of patriots to be sacrificed.
I am playing the long game here, comrade. But with the great urgency of now, it is foolish to fight the war on the terms of your enemy. The revolution must be born in the hearts of the people. If their genes were to be transferred from generation to another, ever growing, never waning. Traore, the only way for the revolution to live on is to exit the eyes of men and enter into the hearts of men. That was what Che did. What Jesus did. To die with your dignity and ideals intact is to live forever.
Comrade, I know many people who have died like that. No one remembers them.
It is not about how you die, but how you choose to die. You see, I choose to die without fear. Full of happiness, knowing that I am the light from the watchtower, leading my brothers and sisters to true freedom. I choose to die free.
Rowdy.
The only ones that people ever remember are those who are not afraid of you.
God, I don't like all the stuff of death. It makes me want to use the toilet.
You know, Jay died when he was 39, 3 years older than me. Jesus, 33, 3 years younger than me. I have outlived Jay. I have outlived Jesus. When I outlived Jay, I do not like the thought of death. Only those who are not afraid of death can truly live for the Lord.
Comrade, you know the rumor is that you have stolen a lot of money and hidden it in Switzerland.
God bears me witness that all that I have are a car, 4 guitars, 4 bicycles, a refrigerator, and a deep freezer. And you know what? That car, I bought it even before I started this. The freezer is even broken down. They say that I stole money. I who don't even have a house.
What do you want to be remembered?
I just want to be remembered simply as someone who lived his life helping humanity. That
what? What? We can call for backup. I know there is a group of CDR loyalists outside. We cannot.
I am the one they have come for.
Comrade, we can fight it.
No.
I spoke with a group of CDR loyalists.
All right. There will be no shedding of blood.
Traore, no, comrade, no. If they want you, they must go to me first.
Traore, drop it, please. Traore, look, we will not shed blood. Let those who sell their conscience and their people, let them shed blood.
But we must protect ourselves.
We will protect ourselves with love, not hate. And you let nothing from me. Look, tell our people that whatever they can dream, they can create. That the enemy has no power over them unless they give them power. Tell Mariam and the children that I love them, my parents and my siblings, that I am thinking of them. Even at this moment, tell our story to our end. Tell them that Africa will rise. Africa for Africa. The revolution is over. Our motherland for death.
We shall overcome.
Our motherland for death.
We shall overcome.
Our motherland or death.
We shall overcome.
Our motherland or death. Our motherland or death. Thank you.
Human rights.